Hello YouTube, SentinalhMC here with ReactorCraft Tutorial Episode 7. I know this isn't the 7th video, but this is my official number 7. So we've talked about fission reactors. I've shown you a small one and I've shown you a big one. Well, not a big one, but a bigger one. And so we've talked about fission reactors, and we've talked about the importance of making sure you keep water in them and make sure they don't go, get too hot. Now we're going to show you what happens when they do get too hot. So this can happen for a variety of reasons. Yeah, for some, maybe you didn't put enough water into the system. Maybe your water supply can't keep up with the demand. Maybe the reactor you built was just a bad design and it was not sustainable. Maybe any number of things could happen. Maybe a creeper blows up your water system and you can't get it in time. But for a variety of reasons, your reactor is heating up too much. And we're going to see what happens. Now, I'm going to simulate that. I've got this. This is the reactor design, the 12-core one, which had control rods. I've built it, but I've left out the control rods, and I'm not going to put any water in these boilers. And I'm going to fill them, the cores, with plutonium fuel pellets. And the reason I'm going to do that is because plutonium fuel pellets, they heat up a lot faster. The cores are going to heat up faster if I use plutonium compared to uranium, because they're a more powerful fuel. Okay, so the first thing that happens when your reactors get hot, your system gets hot, is that it will light flammable nearby blocks on fire. So the cores are only around 200-something at the moment. These tanks are around 345. Now everything's on fire. Stuff's getting up to 500 degrees. You see the particles coming off the reactor cores, letting you know it's getting very hot. 800. This is going to go off very quickly. There's a lot of neutrons bouncing around inside the reactor from these cores. They're not being cooled. 1300 degrees. I think once we get up to around 1800, these will go off. So if you're using plutonium fuel, be careful. It's up to 1400 degrees. See all the little neutrons flying around, the little blue balls. 1300, 1300, 1300, 1400. Come on. 1600, we're getting there. 'Cause if I thermally insulated this by putting some blocks in, it would go a bit faster. I want to be able to see the cores though. This should go off pretty soon. You'll notice that this makes a lot of noise, and it's quite noticeable. So honestly, if this is what's going on, there's really no excuse for you to not notice this, in my opinion. You should never assume that your reactor is foolproof, and you should never just leave it alone. Let's just put some blocks around. Reactors are subject to whims of fate. Now, one thing you've really got to watch out for if you're on a server, we'll get away from the sound effect because that's pretty loud. One thing you've got to watch out for if you're on a server is make sure that your reactor is chunk loaded properly. Try and build your reactors in a single chunk, and you need to use a chunk loader. If the reactor, why is it cooling down? I just want cores in. More cores. Now I need some more reflectors. Come on, baby. Blow up. just some more plutonium. There we go. Explosion. Okay, so the cores exploded. Not all of them. But cores blew up. These will blow up soon enough, probably. And a couple of things happened. The first thing you'll notice, quite a nice explosion. The crater wasn't all that big. But it did throw a lot of debris around, and if this was inside of your building's probably not there anymore. Okay. That's one thing. Now, this was a core meltdown. There are other ways your things can explode. For instance, if we used, if there was like molten sodium in this. I mean, ammonia. Ammonia is a working fluid that you can put in these things. Can't do it. I don't know. But anyway, the reactor has melted down. We're going to get rid of these cores just so that they quit making all that noise. But now you're left with the cleanup. See this zombie over here? He's taking damage from radiation poisoning. You see how all this grass is dying? It's because of the radiation. You see this zombie over here? He's got radiation poisoning. You see these spiders over here? This guy here's got radiation poisoning. Okay, now, that Enderman over there, he's dying of radiation. If I take, these are radiation goggles, and if I put these radiation goggles on, you'll be able to see, if we back up here, you'll be able to see the radiation that we've got around here. See all these green dots? That's all radiation. This whole area is irradiated. I'm currently wearing a hazmat suit, in case you're wondering what that was. This whole area is irradiated, and these mobs are all dying of radiation poisoning. I wonder if creepers just die or if they explode. They just die. Alright, so these guys are all gonna die. All this grass is turning to dirt. All these plants are turning into these little dead bushes. And we've still got a lot of problems here at the reactor itself. So, first thing you'll notice, all the nuclear waste that was inside the reactor cores is sitting on the ground. That's bad. Because this nuclear waste will never despawn. It will never despawn, and it will continuously put out radiation. So, if you ever want the radiation to go away, you gotta clean it up. You gotta clean up the nuclear waste. However, there's another problem. All this black crap. What is this black crap? This is called corium. Corium is a name that you give to the... Basically what this corium is, it's the melted nuclear fuel mixed with the melted fuel core casings. So it's like steel and crap. It's not good stuff. And this corium, it stays like this. Okay? Now, if I grab some water, I don't know if this will actually work. Pour some water on it. Oh, I'm actually just putting water in the steam boiler. Ha. That's funny. Pour some water on this thing. We got obsidian. So we've got obsidian. We've turned the uppermost bit of this corium into obsidian. Alright. So it's going to be a long and difficult cleanup. Anyway. Put water on it, the stuff will start turning into cobblestone, and you can get rid of it. Now, I am wearing a hazmat suit, but I don't know if that means I can actually survive this radiation. I was having it earlier where I was still dying. Let's go out here to where the radiation isn't, and I'm pretty sure it isn't because the area isn't dead, and these guys don't have radiation poisoning. Actually, these guys are all going to kill me if I do that. Let's set the time to day. Time is day. All these mobs are dying. We will go into survival mode. I've got my hazmat suit on. We know that there's radiation up here. So let's go over there. Okay. Oh. Radiation sickness. Now I don't actually know why, because I've got my hazmat. Oh wait. It would appear that I've got the radiation sickness, but I'm not actually taking the damage from it. Hazmat suit. Okay. Oh, there we go. Damage. Poison. Terribleness. What, are you going to explode on me? Oh, goodness. So it would appear that even with the radiation suit, the hazmat suit, this area is just too irradiated. From what Reika has said, you can hold nuclear waste in your hand if you've got a hazmat suit on. At any rate, I'm back in creative mode because I'm going to die otherwise. We'll put this radiation goggles back on. Oh, and now it's raining. So, a good note about rain is that it does help to clean this radiation up. Because here's the kicker, guys. You cannot do a single thing about this radiation. This green stuff, yeah, you can't get rid of it. There's no machine you can place down. There's no chemicals you can spray over it. There's nothing that you, as a player, can do to directly eliminate this radiation. Okay? You just have to wait until it goes away on its own. Okay? Once there... eventually it will. The rain helps to wash it out. It does get carried on the wind. This is going to cause a lot of havoc. If you're on a server, get ready to be the least liked person on the server. If you I would say. Put our water down and let me get a white crystal pendant from Geostrata. Because it does work at getting rid of the radiation sickness. So if you have Geostrata, if you're using Geostrata as well as ReactorCraft, there you go. Okay, so as we can see, we're cleaning up the cobblestone that was left by the water hitting the corium that was flowing. You'll notice that we've also got these blocks, corium blocks. Right there. This stuff is also bad news. Let's grab a pickaxe because I know you can get rid of it with a iron pickaxe. Let's get rid of this new one. Here, we'll put our hazmat helmet back on. I've got my white crystal pendant, so I should be good. Nope, not good. Never mind. Okay, so I was still dying. So this stuff's bad news. Now the corium, it stays here. It's a block. You gotta get rid of it. So you can pick it with pickaxe. I know that. I'm in creative, so I'm just bashing it. Let's get rid of this water. As you can see, there's a whole lot of ways in which a melted down reactor or other nuclear explosion is a very bad thing that you want to avoid like the plague. We got all this corium to clean up. Can't do anything with it. It's just crap. It's the melted nuclear fuel mixed with the steel from the reactor core. creates a whole bunch of junk. Turns the dirt into glass. So that's the size of our crater that we made. Obviously, if you've got a bigger reactor, you've got an even worse problem. The bigger your reactor is, the bigger the explosion, right? Bad news. Bad news. You don't want this to happen to you. Because you have to go, and you have to leave. You can't stay here. It's death. You have to wait until the radiation levels sink down to where you can survive being here. I especially like how the explosion throws all this debris around. That's cool. Okay, so, it's pretty nasty. Now, the reactor itself going off is not the only thing that can cause a nuclear event, an exposure event. Spent fuel containers. These guys that you put your nuclear waste in. If I can spell nuclear right. Just grab some particularly bad stuff. Where's the red stuff? I'll grab some iodine-131. We'll put it into this bent fuel container. And we're not currently cooling this. It's going to explode quite quickly. Drops its waste on the ground. If I put my goggles on, it also creates a localized radiation area. Let's go over here and do that again, where there is no radiation at all. Over here. Place this down, fill it with nuclear waste, and we'll see how much radiation is produced. Quite a lot. So you don't want this to happen to you either. Both of these situations are bad situations. They're not good. There's a hardcore dungeon over there. You don't want this to happen. We got the radiation, the stuff's dying. Push this zombie over. No, he's not gonna get infected, I guess. Okay. He was punching me, that's why. But yeah, these guys now have radiation poisoning and they're dying. So radiation is nothing to to laugh at. This stuff is bad. And when you're dealing with nuclear reactors, you have to take a lot of precautions. Be very careful. Make sure that your spent fuel containers are surrounded with water. Make sure... Oh, hey, there's a Soundcraft aura node here. Make sure that your reactor is well maintained. Check it and check it often. Don't just assume that your reactor core is going to take care of itself. Don't just lock it away, never look at it. Because you don't want this to go. You don't want this to happen to you. It's bad. So yeah, this is what'll happen. Nuclear events are bad. Very bad. Creeper's got radiation poisoning. Radiation poisoning is very bad. It lasts for a very long time. The poison will kill you. It's not good. So take care of your fission reactors, guys. You can get a lot of power out of them, but you can get a lot of trouble if you're not careful. And remember, when you're on a server, you need to make sure that your reactor is always chunk loaded. Okay? If you're on a server and they don't let you have chunk loaders, I don't know how you're going to build a fission reactor safely, unless you're in an area that is like a town that's always loaded. But if your reactor gets unloaded, you're going to have a very, very bad time, because it causes a lot of issues which will result in your reactor exploding. I guess from what I understand, what ends up happening is that it basically amasses neutrons, because from what I understand, the neutrons continue to accumulate, but they don't go away, they just stay there. So once the chunk gets loaded again, the reactor cores are full of neutrons. They immediately heat up by like a million degrees and explode. I think that is why unloading causes issues. Anyway, that's about all I've got about this. If this happens, you know, there's a big cleanup to do, and it's not going to be easy. I couldn't even get close to this thing with my hazmat suit on without dying of radiation poisoning. So you gotta, it's not a good thing. It's not a good thing. So anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the episode. I hope you've enjoyed the explosions. So make sure this doesn't happen to you, because this is on a test world, but you don't want this happening in a world that you've actually put a lot of effort into. So I hope you've enjoyed. I'm SentinalhMC, and I'm signing out.